Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, and you're actually watching it. You're looking at it right now, something I wanted to talk to you about.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Oh, we got a new lens in here. It's the 85mm 1.8 Z mount for the Nikon Z6, which is an older camera, to be honest with you. But it gives me a beautiful picture. It does beautiful focus. I mean, it's actually one of those under-the-radar cameras. You could buy the camera itself for $1,000. But because the camera is quite a ways from where I sit, the 50mm wasn't enough reach. I had to enlarge it too much. So we really needed an 85mm lens. So I went looking and shopping, and I have a friend named Randy, who's in Texas, has his own channel, Randall Brander. And we started looking at 85mm lenses. So, of course, Nikon makes one for their own camera, 85mm 1.8. There's a Yang-un, something to that, similar to that, that makes one. And then Viltrox makes one. So how we came to the conclusion of Viltrox is because the Viltrox that you're looking at right now actually has 9 blades. So with the blades, this is what the lens looks like, by the way, just so you can see that's the box. See how well we focus here if I don't have the glare and if I don't tilt it the wrong way? Okay, so that's what the lens looks like. So we are at 1.8. So you get a beautiful blurred background. Now, if you look at the lights on the tree and the background, let's see, let's put the box down here. All right, let me put my finger up. Right there. So right, I have a light dancing on the tip of my finger, okay? Isn't that cool? All right, so right at the tip of my finger there, that light, if that's called a specular light. It's like a spot, a source of light that is small, and they call that specular. Now, if you look at that light, actually, you can look at any of the lights that are on the tree. There's another one right there. Anywhere I stick my finger, there's a light on the tree. Okay, so those lights, if you look at those specular lights, that's one of the ways where you can define if the bokeh, some people call it bokeh, like a flower bokeh. Some people call it bokeh, B-O-K-A-H. That's your choice. Whatever you like. Okay, there's no bokeh police here, but there's a couple of things that describe what that light at the end of my fingertip. That's pretty cool. The way I can do that looks like. All right. So there's two ways to be looking at the quality of this lens. Now, the number of blades that are in the lens itself actually makes for a higher quality bokeh. All right. So if it becomes like a five-sided or, where you see a bunch of sides, six sides, okay, that means that the number of blades that's in the lens is not high enough. So this one's got 9 blades, and that's why we chose this one. I believe the Nikon has 9 blades also. Now, the Nikon brand, which is a Z mount, which is native, it'll mount directly on this Z6 camera. And you can tell what you're looking at, like here. Now, that's a sign. That's not part of the background, okay? That's a sign I put up on the screen, all right? And if you look at the roundness of the light that you've got right there, and if you could see, is it fuzzy? Is it glowing? That's the sign of a better lens. So sharpness is another sign of a good lens. Chromatic aberration is another sign of a lens. Now, this lens is half the price of the Nikon. The Nikon is an 85mm 1.8. And it's made by Nikon, so it's native to their own camera. This Viltrox is made in China. It's a Chinese lens, okay? So you guys that are not liking to buy Chinese products or made in China, good luck, because it's hard. Even my underwear is made in China. Well, maybe not. All right. But the point of the fact is that the price is significantly lower, and not just a little bit. It's not like 25% off, 30%. It's half. So they list at $399 unless it goes on sale. Now, you could look at the quality that's going on this lens. Now, I also have the 35 millimeter that fits on here also. It's their full frame lenses. So I wanted to bring this to your attention. So if you're coming into the Nikon line, let's say you're leaving Sony and you're coming into the Nikon line and you can't afford all the high price lenses, well, you've got Sigma is a third party lens company that makes lenses. You've got, of course, Nikon. They make their own lenses for their own cameras. And that would probably be the creme de la creme of what you would want to get for the best lens that works with the camera. But this lens, I got to say, it works great. It picks up the focus because sometimes they don't. See, if I put it there, it focuses beautifully. So you see the tape? They've got their name printed on the tape there. So that means you can't get somebody to open it at the camera store and then just put another piece of tape over it. You could tell because the tape is actually labeled. So on the negative side, it doesn't have a lens hood. It gives you a pouch so you can put your lens in a pouch. But many of us, including me, we actually have a camera case, you know, where we put our equipment in. All right. So the pouch is nice, but I would prefer a lens hood, but it doesn't have a lens hood. But it does have a spot for the lens hood, and it's sitting right there. All right. So I wanted to bring that to your attention because I've got the 85 1.8, very sharp. All right. Look at the strands of my hair. You could see right here. Is the Nikon a little sharper? I would say that the Nikon is a little sharper, but I didn't get a hands-on look. But Randy, the gentleman that donated this lens to the Christmas room, this lens was donated by one of you guys. Okay, that's how the viewers here they buy and donate things for the Christmas room. So if you'd like to do that, the number on your screen will be there for the next 20 minutes. No, we don't have a number on the screen. All right. So I wanted to bring this lens to you because it could save you money. It's going to do you good. It works really well. This is an older camera. This is not even a newer Nikon camera. This camera's got to be 3 or 4 years old. This is the Z6, not the Z6 Mark II. So the camera's got to be 3 to 4 years old. And this camera, it does it absolutely beautifully. So it comes highly recommended. I also have the 35 millimeter 1.8, highly recommended. The camera's too far for me to use it. But if I was going to take the camera off and take it over to your house because you were having a birthday party, chances are I'd probably put on the 35 millimeter 1.8. Lets enough light in. The focus is great. The lens is sharp. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put a link. I'll put a link to Adorama in the description below. Number one, if you want to buy one, use the link. It helps the channel. Number two, you don't have to buy one to use the link. Use the link so you can go over there and look at the pictures and look at the specs of the lens and look at the comments that other people are making. So, you know, somebody might give it 1 star because they wanted a silver-bodied lens and it's black. All right, just ignore that kind of a comment because it's not telling you about the lens. But if you read the comments, most people are really, really happy. And you don't need to read my comment. I'm sitting right here, right now. My face is on your phone, on your iPad, or on your computer, and you're looking at the 85 millimeter Viltrox lens at 1.8. So this is as wide as it's going to go. So it does a good job. It's highly recommended. Use the link to go look at the pictures. I'm going to link it probably two places. I'll link it at Adorama, which is where I think, I'm not sure if Randy bought this at Adorama or not. And I'll put the one for BH Photo, okay? So you'll have a choice. So you can read the comments, see what people think. You don't only have to take my opinion. There's quite a few comments on the lens. just remember to look at the number of blades before you just start looking at prices for the lower price lenses. The ones that don't have at least like 8 or 9 blades in the lens, you're not going to get that beautiful round, if I can get my finger on there again, ding, I feel like, look, the tip of my finger's all lit up right there. Okay, so see how round, and they're on the edge, okay, as well as right behind my ear over here. See that one there? They're round. The quality is good. The quality is there. It could be a tad sharper if you wanted to look at it in a lab, under lab tests, and that's where the Nikon is going to give you the double the price. But we're not missing sharpness here. I mean, let's call it the way it is. It's sharp. It's actually can be too sharp. I'm going to be 70 years old in a few months. I'm not looking to show you every pore, every wrinkle, and every age spot on my skin. So sharpness has its place, but there is such a thing as being over sharp. So this is a big thumbs up, Viltrox 85 millimeter, 1.8. We're watching it. The link is in the description. You can look at pictures and you can look at other people's opinions. That is just as important. Thank you for watching. Catch you later. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Bye-bye. Whoosh.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.